In this video, let's learn how to use Khan Academy as a teacher. When you go to Khan Academy, you need to register for free and create your login. Once you have created a login, then you can go to settings, and in settings, if you scroll down, it says what role do you want. So by default, everyone in Khan Academy is a learner. And then you can say whether you also want your role to be defined as a teacher and as a parent. So let's say I have selected all of them, and let's see how to use Khan Academy now. You can scroll up and you will now have something called the teacher dashboard. So you can click on teacher dashboard and let's get started. So it's saying what classes are you teaching? Let's say class 8, whatever you want to select. Let's say I'm saying also maybe physics, biology, and maybe even chemistry, and maybe computer programming. So these are the subjects as a teacher I'll be teaching, and I'm saying continue. So this is the class that has got created, and because we selected grade 8, that is what it is showing. And here if I click, then I am coming to the student roster. And of course, I don't have any students right now, so I can add students. And here the important thing to note is that this class has a unique code, this number here. So I say add students, and then there are three ways to invite your students to join your classroom. One is that if you have a Google Classroom, you can import from there, or you can create a link and send it to your students, or you can create your students' accounts, and in which case you will enter the student names and Khan Academy will create the password that you can then customize. Let me use this one. So I say two students in my class, I've assigned them names AP and MP. These are the passwords which can be configured, and I say create accounts. We recommend downloading a CSV spreadsheet of your students' usernames and passwords for privacy reasons. This is the only time you will be allowed to access the password list. So let me just download and keep it. And accounts have been created, and I'm saying done. So like this, we have added some students here. Let's also try add new students with a class link, in which case it's just this link, and anyone with this link can send this link, and they can use that to join your class on Khan Academy. So if I go to a new browser window and I paste the link. So when I paste this link, I come here and it's saying join your class. And if the student doesn't have a Khan Academy account, they can create one. So I'm saying create an account. Sign up with email. So I have signed up using a link, and I am now a part of that class that I had created as a teacher. So it's showing me here, your teachers, Atul Pant. So let's see, now I have logged in as a student here, and let's say I take some class. So I'm going on courses. So this is now the student login. And let's say the student starts with some basic addition and subtraction. So they are in, and again here, they can watch a video.
So 1 + 1 is equal to 2. Now,
even if the accent is a bit difficult, you can switch on the closed captions and you will see the red line to say that closed captions are on. And whatever is being said, you can also read it like a subtitle.
Well, let's stick with the avocados.
So let's say I have watched this video as a student, and then I start doing some mastery exercises. So it's saying ready to practice, 7 questions, takes 7 to 11 minutes. Let's go. How much is 1 + 3? Now, if you don't know, if as a student I do not know this, then I can watch a video or use a hint, or I can answer, or here even the scratch pad opens up. So, which is interesting, because if let's say the sum was 10 + 4, then as a student, I could have written here 10 + 4, and then done the carry over, or let's say if this was 18 plus 4, then I would say 8 plus 4 is 2, and 1 carry over, and it's 2, so it's the answer is 22. So the point is that Khan Academy gives you all these very interesting tools right there on your screen that can be used, for example, for doing rough work, and then putting in the answer, and then you can check the answer, and it's saying nice work, you've got it right, next question. I'm just showing you that the idea of mastery learning here. Now, if as a student I've answered 6 questions, then it's already saying that I have come up one level. That's the idea of mastery learning. It's saying I've already become familiar with this topic because I have answered these many questions correctly without taking a hint. This means that I have gained mastery over this particular topic of addition, and hence it's saying that I have leveled up. I've got all 7 of 7 correct, and I've gained some energy points, etc., which is the gamification aspect of Khan Academy, which as a student I'll get badges and all for my encouragement. So I say done here. If as a student I go up here and I go to learn a home, in the student dashboard, of course, this is whatever courses I had selected earlier. But then if I go here and I click on progress, then it generates a report. Now it's saying that latest activity may take 10 minutes to show below. So what I just did, that part is not available, but I guess this is tracking something else that I had done earlier on this laptop. But it's showing me that in the last 7 days, I have done 1 exercise minute and 3 total minutes of learning. So as a student, the strong point of Khan Academy is all the analytics it makes available to the student. And you can go and say that, what kind of activities have I done? So how many exercises did I do? How many videos did I watch? How many quizzes did I take? How many mastery challenges I attempted? So forth. This learner analytics is a very useful feature of Khan Academy. So let's go back to the teacher login. So now I've got 3 students. You remember 2 we had added ourselves, and the third one joined using a link. So this is that third one. I should have used some other name, but anyway, AP. And what I can do is, as a teacher, I can look at the learner analytics of all my students. So I can see that this student called AP has done a total of 4 exercise minutes and 7 total minutes of learning. And this is what this student did right now. So let's not look at this mean median mode, which I think my laptop just picked up from something I had done earlier. But as AP, what I've done is what this student has done, and as a teacher, I can see is that some basic addition video this student watched and then did some arithmetic exercises. And level is, it's showing me all these things that this student is proficient in these 2 skills. And likewise, if I go and if I switch my student and I go to the other student, then of course, this student hasn't done anything because nobody has used this login, and hence there is no data available. So let's go back to AP, and then here, if you had given some assignment, etc., you would have got all those details here. The reason why I think Khan Academy is so helpful for a teacher is because you imagine that in your whole class, if you had given your students some set of exercises to do, so they would have done it. And then as a teacher, you would log in to the backend. You could get these analytics for your students, and that will give you a very good idea that which student is not performing well in which topic. And in the classroom, then you could focus on that student for that particular topic. And I've also heard that some teachers, the way they use Khan Academy is that, for example, let's say there were 25 students in your class, and maybe 10 of them did not understand something. Let's say they didn't understand addition, and 10 of the other students did get addition. So then what the teachers do is they also sometimes assign the student who who understands that concept to the student who doesn't understand, you know, like a buddy. And then utilize peer learning so that the students can teach each other. So that's why I think Khan Academy, which is absolutely free and has great content for science and maths for sure, and for other subjects also, and offers this mastery learning, learner analytics, and also this kind of an overview that it gives to the teacher, which gives great insights to the teacher on where the students are getting stuck. So if a lot of students are getting stuck on a certain concept, then you could focus more on that concept. So I hope I've been able to explain why Khan Academy is such a great resource to use, and I hope you will make the most of it.